You open the choke, start producing the oil. So what happens? Where will it start to produce most oil?
A horizontal well will typically start producing more oil at the heel section of the well pipe and wherever there are high permeability zones in the reservoir. Let's say you have one here and a low permeability zone here. The flow rate will be larger in the heel section and high permeability zone compared to the flow rate in the lower permeability zone and the toe section. This is because there is more resistance to fluid flow in the low permeability zone and because the differential pressure between the reservoir and the wellbore is lower at the toe section, each resulting in a decreased flow rate. Consequently, step one of production entails draining oil in only certain predetermined areas. Depending on the reservoir, this process can take anywhere from a few weeks to a few months. As the oil is being drained, step two of production occurs. This is a major oil field issue known as water or gas coning. Coning is a term describing the upward movement of water or the downward movement of gas as a consequence of the decreasing oil. This causes the unwanted fluids to be drawn into the well, replacing oil in the production stream. The term water cuts is used to describe the ratio of water compared to the volume of total liquids produced in the well. The term gas to oil ratio refers to the amount of gas being produced in comparison to oil. Of course, the aim is to produce oil with the lowest possible water cut and GOR values. But the problem is that once a water or gas breakthrough occurs, the flow rate of these fluids will be significantly higher than the flow rate of the oil. This is due to the lower viscosity of water and gas, a factor which we know from Darcy's law is inversely proportional to the flow rate, meaning the lower the viscosity, the higher the flow rate. Because of the higher flow rates of water and gas downhole, you need to have high water and gas separation and handling capacities at the surface of the well. However, there are limits to these capacities. When exceeded, the only solution is to initiate step 3 of production, reducing the well choke size. Doing so reduces the pressure drawdown and therefore reduces the flow rate and the production of water and gas in breakthrough areas. Unfortunately, it also means a reduction of the flow rate in the areas where you're producing oil. This is why the majority of reservoir oil never gets produced. The areas that favour faster oil production also favour early water or gas breakthrough, which in turn force the choking of the entire well, leaving oil-rich zones unrecovered.